Morning! Hello and welcome to the last day of the Disney trip and the beautiful Wilderness Lodge. Today we are heading to Magic Kingdom. I'm just off to refill the resort mugs, and as a little reminder, this vlog is very kindly sponsored by World of DVC. If you'd like to know more about the Unlock Magic service, which is their subscription service to help you get the most out of planning your Disney trip, stick around. I'll tell you more about that later.
Good morning, Wilderness Lodge.
Because we went to Magic Kingdom for the morning last time, we're actually going to go afternoon, evening to make sure that we are there for Happy Ever After. We've also got the dessert party booked, which is the pre-party. So we go about 7:50 to go and have desserts and stuff like that, and then we get escorted to the what used to be the Fast Pass Plus viewing area. And then we can watch the fireworks, which would be great. I've managed to book Tron for this evening because we weren't doing the virtual queue for the morning, and also we're not sure if we're definitely going to be in the park for the virtual queue drop at 1 p.m. I thought it was best to just book a lightning lane so we know that we could go on it again. So yeah, but I think our plan is to go to lunch at the, what is it called, Geyser Point. Rachel's wearing a little purple Dorothy number. She's already had a compliment today.
Yes.
Which she overheard. She wasn't supposed to hear it.
No, but it made me smile.
Whilst this does look like open seating, you do have to join a waitlist with the greeter, who's normally around here.
Oh, this all looks so good. Cheeseburger, chicken sandwich, crab cakes. Ooh.
Donald, this is a restaurant. You should put some clothes on.
It's crazy that that's the fish cake portion, and then this is. The and then we got some edamame to share as well, which is nice.
Yeah.
Well, that was a very lovely lunch.
Delicious.
It was nice, wasn't it?
A very nice little atmosphere in there as well.
Yeah, and I think for the quality of the food and the price, I would give it a 5 out of 5.
I would actually.
It was less than $50 for both of us to have a soft drink and a lunch, and we also had an appetizer at edamame there as well.
Which seemed to be an endless bowl.
Yeah.
Just never ended.
The portion size of my burger was great. Crab cakes to be questioned, but they were quite fresh and everything.
They were delicious. I just wish there was a bit more of them.
Yeah.
Like they could have had, if they wanted to do that size, they could have had 3 of them on the plate.
Yeah, I would agree. But I think about like $15 per entree.
Pretty decent.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
Where are we going now, Rachel?
Magic Kingdom.
And I think we just missed the boat.
Oh no!
Should we take the bus?
How long will it be till the next boat?
Up to 20 minutes, I think.
Okay. Are you sure it was that boat?
I mean, it's going away from here.
For your safety and the safety of others, please remain seated while the motor coach is in motion.
This is where we're coming at 7:50. So they have the pre-party, which we've got, the seats and suites, which is the most expensive and hardest to get, and the post-party, which I think is the same price as the pre-party, but you have the desserts after the fireworks. It looks like it's starting to rain, so we're gonna take a ride on the People Mover. I look like I'm one of the traitors from the BBC show.
Oh my God, you do.
I'm a faithful Darren.
I swear to you.
Are you 100%? Are you 100%?
I'm 100% faithful, I swear. Claudia, back me up here. Come on, I'm faithful.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, the rain has started. Farewell, Charlie Beagle.
Greetings, intergalactic travelers. Welcome aboard the People Mover, presented by Enterprise. Don't worry, your express train keeps on rolling through the future, right by two of my favorite spots. Did you know Progress City inspired Epcot? And a lot of the visionary ideas throughout Walt Disney World. Look, there's even a tiny People Mover.
Let relaxation wash over you at the most refreshing retreat in the galaxy, the Coral Moons of Pisces 7. You H2O it to yourself. Book today.
As usual, we'll keep moving ahead, and so does the carousel. Like Progress itself, this theater never stops. Fellowship. Hop aboard and launch high above Tomorrowland.
Shaker not stirred is right. Oh god. Oh, get me off. I'm getting too old for this. I miss the escalator that used to bounce on coming down here.
Why did they get rid of it?
I'm assuming it just kept breaking down. I like that. It's like, is it a teapot?
Space Mountain mug with the lid.
$24.99. Nightmare to clean though. You know you're an adult when you start looking at merchandise going like, oh, be a nightmare to wash that though.
You look like you've got a fishbowl on your head.
Because I have a fishbowl on my head. Also, you can only hear yourself in here. It's really weird.
Hello.
Hello. How much is that?
One side. $69.99.
To walk around with a bucket on your head. I'm alright, thanks. We're now going to take the Storybook Circus path that is near Tron, which is brand new, which will take us over to the Barnstormer, and we're going to head round to It's a Small World because it's got a relatively short wait. They have the sour belts. The snacks. I love these. They've stolen Rachel's outfit to make some ears.
I didn't get any royalties for
this. How many? It's probably $34.99.
Yeah. I don't need more ears. I've got the best pair of ears in the galaxy.
Ah. You're right there, Rachel.
I'm being bored.
She's currently using the Mears Connect poncho I had in my owner's locker because someone didn't bring a raincoat this time.
No, I know. I was wishful thinking that it would be...
We have been lucky for the most part.
Yeah, no, and we've generally only had like a few droplets here and there where I can just hold my coat over my head.
Not in this. We're currently huddled in the Be Our Guest greeting station. And we were talking about how this is probably one of the harder reservations to get in Disney World. World of DVC are very kindly sponsoring this vlog series, and they have a subscription service called Unlocked Magic. And the best tool in that subscription is something called the Disney Dining Reservation Finder. So if you are having trouble getting Be Our Guest, that system will scan all the reservations available and then notify you when it's available. Pretty handy. It also has the best discount on Walt Disney World tickets and a great community of people to help you plan your ultimate trip in the little forum that they've got on there. So if you want to check it out, there is a link in the description. It's $5.99 per month if you just want to do on a monthly basis, or you can get it for the whole year for $49.99. You can get the first month free with my code MORNING. And all the information's in the description if you want to check it out. You okay there?
Yes. I'm wearing a plastic bag.
Sister Lanning, meet Sister Hattan.
Hello, Sister.
Hello. Hello. Should we go on It's a Small World now?
I think that might be a good idea.
Because it's indoors. Oh, lovely. Lady. In the queue, Rachel was singing, do you ever feel like a plastic bag? It'd be raining. So we don't really know what to do. We're gonna kill some time, maybe on the Liberty Bell if it's operating.
I'm a bit wet.
This is Magic Kingdom on a rainy day, I suppose.
We were stuck between like a rock and a hard place as to what to do because we booked Lightning Lanes for Tron at
six,
which would give us like just enough time to go into the dessert party.
Just that's at seven,
yeah,
right?
yeah. So we're basically like we don't want to hang around, but then we don't have time to go back to the room because we have to go back if Tron. Anyway. We went into the ticket office just here where they have some guest service cast members, and the very lovely Matt was very helpful. He was like, do you want me to just check and see if there's a time that's earlier? Because then you could do that and then go back to the resort and then just come back for the fireworks. And he did! So we're gonna go and do Tron now, which is great.
Oh goodness. It's a river!
Yee! But at least some people are enjoying the rain.
The kids in the puddles.
Well, it's a good thing you wore those.
Oh god, yeah.
Not Converse. You were thinking about that.
Yeah. I really would be having farty shoes.
You are about to be digitized into the world of Tron. For your safety in this world, all users should be in good health.
Let's go!
Hello everyone, welcome to Chin's Cam. On today's show, we're on Tron Light Cycle Run! I think I'm definitely warming up to, like, I know the track layout now, and it's like good fun. Near the front's very, very fast. My hair is very windswept. Although as we were going around, it is pouring down.
Pouring?
Like raining.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
We've officially been rained out. Our feet are wet. We're cold. We'll go back to the resort.
Don't mind me. I'm trying to dry on my raincoat before we go out again. Change my shorts. Oh, legs 11.
Oh, give me some of that.
Your makeup is now set.
Thank you!
I was looking at myself in the mirror and I was like, I don't really go together. My blue backpack, my red t-shirt, my green jacket, my orange shorts. I look very British right now.
Like, you can tell I'm British just by looking at me. That's a Brit on holiday.
Yeah.
You, on the other hand, look like a Disney princess.
That's really sweet. Thank you. You're a welcome. Soggy Disney princess.
A soggy Disney princess.
Yeah, yeah.
But a princess nonetheless.
Oh, it's nice and warm in here.
Bloop. Right. What is the point of that button if it doesn't do anything? We were just thinking, like, maybe it won't rain. Maybe we'll be fine. They've just closed the pool because there's lightning in the area. Oh well!
Ominous!
Ominous! I think you can actually see the rain coming across the lake. Just literally as we step out, it started raining again, for goodness sake. We were waiting for the boat. We waited about like 10-20 minutes and we got talking to a lovely family. But I don't think they run the boats when there's lightning in the area. And we can hear thunder and stuff like that, so.
And the pool's still closed, so.
The pool's still closed and we were like, we know the bus is running, let's go for the bus. So, we're having a quick walk to hopefully get the one that's in 5 minutes. Okay, folks, knees up, knees up, knees up. Don't run, but walk with purpose. We can do this, we can do this, we can do this. Please open. Open, thank you. Oh. I was like, it's not gonna open. We made it. Rachel nearly went flying, but
I needed to grab the railing.
How are you feeling about our life choices, Rachel?
Well, it's one thing when you're standing outside and it starts raining. It's another thing when you've got to get off a nice toasty bus and step into it.
I know. And it's like, it's not light. Because of the weather situation, stopping the boats and everything like that, we're probably going to get in about 10 minutes late to the party, but I'm hoping they'll still take us. Oh my god. How are you?
Doing well.
Trying to stay out of the river.
Yes, it's a good strategy.
Okay,
thank you.
We
have made it. We're not the only people that are running a little bit behind as well. So, just goes to show, all good. We made it, what time is it now?
54, 4 minutes.
4 minutes late!
Five of you guys at this table here.
Awesome, thank you. Martin, I can't pronounce that, but it's sparkling cider. Cheers! Woo! America, I like your sparkling cider. We don't have that in the UK. I think it's non-alcoholic.
Yeah, I was going to say, that doesn't taste like alcohol, but that's still very nice.
But there is a bar over there, so if you want to get a drinky drink.
You know it!
So you pick up your plate and utensils first. Chocolate silk pie, cookies and cream cheesecake mousse, chilling chamber pot, chocolate covered strawberries, tres leche, I don't know, I'm butchered that. Devil's chocolate pudding, firehouse donuts, butterscotch pudding, chocolate and vanilla cake bites, assorted fruits, assorted cheeses, assorted breads, sugar cookies and chocolate chip cookies. They've also got a warm caramel apple crepe. This looks amazing. Soft beverages, they have Pog juice, which is otherwise known as jungle juice, strawberry lemonade, Minute Maid lemonade, unsweetened iced tea, water with lemon and milk. They also have Joffrey's coffee, as well as decaf, and a hot tea selection. Here's a look at the alcohols that they have available. I'm gonna try this apple strudel crepe thing because this is the hot thing, so I think I should eat it first.
Yeah,
it's like apple pie but in a pancake. Rachel's definitely getting the money's worth out of this.
I got you more cheese and grapes.
Yay!
And a fresh one of them.
Aw, thank you.
You're welcome.
See, I think if you're a big drinker of beer or wine, you could very easily make your money back on this.
Yeah.
Well, not make it back, but like you could get the money's worth out of it. So, like the benefit to me is the firework viewing area because I don't really do crowds. I don't know, not very well anyway. So that's the main selling point to me. But if you like sweet treats and wine,
hi.
So we are going to the viewing area just here, which used to be a Fast Pass Plus viewing area. Hello!
Hi.
So, one of you? Thank you very much. Everyone's welcome in.
Thank you.
We've come in only 5 minutes before.
Perfect.
And this is the view we've got. It's great. The only criticism with this viewing area, which Gary doesn't like, because I know this, is that some of the light fixtures are getting in the way of the castle. But unless you need the absolute perfect picture, you get a great view of the fireworks.
I've literally got a single speaker blocking one turret.
Yeah,
and that's
You'll still see the fireworks.
But it's not too crowded, like there is plenty of space to stand. Some people are sitting at the back. Lovely.
Unless you don't mind wet blockies.
Yeah, and it's not raining.
No.
We appreciate that. Da, 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 da. Woo! My magic band!
I think mine's run out of battery.
Oh. All we have to do is look inside our hearts and unlock the magic within.
Ready to begin. Let the wonder take hold.
Multicolored. Rachel didn't charge her.
Yeah.
love them.
That was so nice.
Have you seen them before?
No, I don't think so. Not that sure. I'm a bit misty-eyed.
The fireworks pre-dessert party was $92.25, or 95 cents, one of the two. It's about $92,
$93
per person, yes. Would you say that was worth the money?
Absolutely, yes.
I would too. I think the fact that we didn't have to camp out for a view, we had this, massive plus. We enjoyed the desserts. Mm-hmm. I enjoyed the cheeses very much.
I enjoyed the wine.
You did enjoy the wine, and the cast members were amazing in there as well. So if you're thinking about doing it, I would really recommend it. The seats and treats, or treats and sweets, something where you sit down and watch the fireworks and have your dessert party and stuff like that.
Seats and sweets.
One of the two. That one's harder to get into, but this one I only booked month in advance, 2 weeks in advance, something like that. So just
still
check on what's available, yeah.
Absolutely.
Rachel's just popped to the loo, and I was just reflecting on, like, today. And at the time we left the park to go back to Wilderness Lodge, we were in such a, like, a rained out mood. And we only had, like, a short amount of time to get back to the resort, chill for, like, maybe 40 minutes and then come back. And we were like, is it worth it? But I'm so, so glad we did, because that literally saved the day. I got to have a little snack, we got to have a little rest, change our stuff. Like, if I hadn't changed out of those soggy shoes into flip-flops, I wouldn't have been the Adam that I was this evening. And we had a lovely time at the dessert party and seeing the fireworks and stuff from a, I think, a really great view. So I would recommend it. We're now gonna head out of the park. It's been a lovely evening, but once we're back at the resort, I'll do like a full trip review of the fun that we've had. Two soggy people.
Yeah.
Back in the room. Okay, so as a little trip roundup, favourite meal?
Oh, I did enjoy the food at the Edison.
Yeah.
I thought that was 5 out of 5, 5+ out of 5.
It was a lovely atmosphere,
but
expensive.
Yes, so in terms of price,
yeah,
overall food quality, atmosphere, service, I think Roundup Rodeo Barbecue.
That was really great.
Gets it for me.
For me, I'm going to go Geyser Point for lunch. Great atmosphere, yeah. Great food, great price, and great service. Highlight of the trip?
The macaws. Animal Kingdom, yeah.
Misty eyes. And I think I told you earlier, what was my highlight? I've forgotten.
Frozen.
Oh!
Yeah!
My highlight was getting stuck on Frozen, where we just heard the same loop like 10 times.
In summer!
Let's do it one more time! It was quite a funny thing for us. So yeah, that was definitely the highlight. But it's been absolutely wonderful having Rachel along.
Thank you very much for coming for having me.
And putting up with all the vlog stuff I've had to do and work stuff I've had to do, but we've had the best time.
It's always a lovely time with you, and I really appreciate you inviting me along.
Feelings mutual. Well, I will be back soon with some magic coming from a different place other than Disney World. So don't forget to subscribe so you see that. And Mr. GC will be back as well. So, in the meantime, check out Rachel's Instagram in the link in the description. And I need to say a very big thank you to World of DVC for sponsoring this series and making the whole trip possible. If you would like to check out DVC Rental Store, DVC Resale Market, Unlocked Magic, links are in the description. They've been awesome and very supportive.
Thank you, World of DVC.
So, in the meantime, please like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to your other future stuff. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.